Hello, Mary here, and I am really excited to tell you a story about something that happened very early on in my coaching business that taught me a huge lesson in pricing. But before I get into that, I invite you to subscribe to this channel to hear from me even more, and don't forget to check out the description box because there are goodies there for you. Be sure to watch all the way to the end because there are some major gems in this video having to do with how to price your coaching if you want to get past that $1,000 to $2,000 per month mark. All right, are you ready for this story? So this takes place back in 2016 when I first started my coaching business. And my coaching business came about in sort of a bizarre way. Compared to most people, I think, because I didn't have any coach training. I didn't really know what a coaching business was supposed to look like. I had used a coach myself, but only in a very kind of casual way. In other words, she didn't charge me anything. So I didn't really have a sense of how any of that was supposed to look. The only thing I knew for sure was that I could help people. I had been having casual conversations with people for about 2 years before I decided to go pro, and I had had a great time, but no one had paid me for these conversations. They were based on a transformation that I had experienced myself, and I just felt like, you know, I really want to bring this to more people, like for real. I want to be a professional coach. Then something happened that really pushed me into the water, made me dive in, which was I lost my job. And I'll probably make another video about that whole scenario because it's actually a really interesting story that relates to why I believe entrepreneurship is such an amazing thing for people to do. But back to the story. So I had had this idea of maybe being a professional coach. I lost my job. It was a very big surprise, to say the least. Maybe it is for a lot of people. And I was staring at a basically empty bank account at the same time. So I was like, I got to do something. Now's the time to become a professional coach. That was what I decided to do. I was so nervous. I really didn't know how to come across as a professional coach up until that time. I had had a personal blog going for a few months that I had gotten maybe 100 people signed up to hear from me. I was sending out a daily audio, which was really cool. And I had maybe another 100 people on an email list that was related to a failed business that I had tried a few years earlier, which had to do with designing websites and videos and things for people. And that just totally didn't work out. So those people really weren't interested in life coaching, certainly, I didn't think, at least. So I was kind of like, well, I'm going to start where I am and see what happens. And the first thing that I had to do was figure out what the heck to even offer. I didn't know how to put a coaching package together. I didn't even know what that was. So I will never forget this. I spent an entire weekend. This was like the most epic weekend ever. Perusing other coaches' websites, trying to get a sense of how they talked about their coaching services and what they offered. I tried to figure out how they priced things. I was basically just trying to get as much information as I possibly could so that I could figure out what to do myself. And at the end of that weekend, through lots of blood, sweat, and tears, and a lot of angst and nerves, I had a sales page up that listed 3 coaching packages. And at the time, I remember thinking, well, I know how much I need to make each month to get the bills paid. And at that point, I really needed the money. I was really struggling a lot. And I knew that I had to price my offers accordingly. I couldn't offer coaching for a few hundred dollars because I needed to make at least $5,000 a month to pay my bills and to, you know, get things moving again. So there I was, putting up these offers. I think one was $1,800, one was maybe $2,100, and I think the top one was $2,400, something like that. And I don't remember the specifics, but it had to do with how much time you spent with me. And you had to pay up front. You couldn't do any sort of monthly payment plans. I wasn't into that. Oh, wow. Was I ever nervous? to make that page go live on that Monday, but I did it. And then I spent a long time crafting an email to go out to this group of people, offering them a chance to talk to me on a Zoom call to see if they wanted to sign up for coaching. And the way that I had it set up was they had to see the prices before they signed up for that free Zoom call. So I wasn't going to surprise them on the call with how much the coaching was. I wanted people to know right up front what they were going to be asked to pay if they wanted my coaching. No surprises. All right. So first call that I ever had with someone interested in my coaching, I will never forget it. We had a great conversation and I was really sure that I could help them with the problem that they were having in their life. And so I got to the point in the conversation where it seemed like the right moment to say, would you like to sign up to work with me? And they said, yes, they would. And here is where I made my rookie mistake and where this lesson just, wow, it was so big. So I said, I'm guessing you want to sign up for the $1,800 package. And you know what they said? No, I want to sign up for the most expensive one. Remind me what the most expensive one is, Mary. Ding, 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 ding. Major light bulb moment. The person wanted the most expensive option. They wanted what they perceived as the best of the best. And wow, was that ever a big lesson. Oh my gosh, I have carried that with me ever since. Some people just want the best and they are willing to pay for it. They see the price as an indicator of value. We know that it's not always true that the price you pay equals the value you receive. We know this, but sometimes it is. Sometimes it is. And for many people, that's all they see. They see the dollar sign and the number after it, and that indicates to them whether something is good or whether it's not. So here's the thing that I want to ask you today. If somebody looked at your prices for what you're offering, what kind of impression would they get? Especially if they are the type of person who only wants the best of the best. Would they look at your pricing and say, wow, this person is the best of the best of what they do. They must be great. They are providing a lot of value. Sign me up. Because I guarantee you, absolutely 100% guarantee you, that there are people in your audience right now, no matter how big your audience is or how small it is, who want to pay a premium price for your coaching and you just haven't offered it yet. I'm going to say that again for emphasis. There are people in your sphere right now. I don't care if you have an email list of zero or an email list of 20,000. There are people there right now who are waiting for that premium offer and you just haven't made it to them yet. You just haven't made it. So what's stopping you? A lot of coaches that I've worked with over the years have a fear of charging what they believe is too much for their coaching. Here's something I can say about that. I have made low-priced offers that people have bought. I have made low-priced offers that people haven't bought. I've made high-priced offers that people have bought, and I have made high-priced offers that people haven't bought. So, numbers are just numbers. For some people, the bigger the number, the better. For other people, the lower the number, the better. If you want to start doubling your income as a coach, if you're making, you know, $1,000 a month or so right now, and you'd like to make that $2,000 or $3,000, guess what you have to do? You can't keep offering things at $100 or $200. You have to have something in there that's $1,000, $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, whatever that number is. You've got to start to put that into your portfolio and just know that you are worth it. I have spoken to coaches who have spent 4 or 5 years in training who still don't feel ready to sell their coaching. I frankly don't understand that, because that to me is some kind of weird psychological thing that must be going on within the coaching industry. I just know that what I have seen from people as a business coach working mostly with other coaches is that most coaches are afraid to charge real money for their coaching. And I want to get rid of that. Okay. Can we just sweep that away once and for all? I want you to know that no matter what type of coaching you're doing, it is worth a significant amount of money. It is valuable and people will pay a higher price. You may find it easier, as I have, to sell things that are higher priced than it is to sell something lower priced. I've seen this over and over again in my own business as both a life coach and as a business coach. Time and again, when I have offered something at a lower price, it's been harder for me to sell it than if I've offered something at a higher price. And frankly, the marketing time is the same in both. So you might as well spend your time, at least most of it, trying to offer something at a higher price that is going to frankly be a better experience for you and your client. You're getting someone who is really invested. And plus, you don't have to have as many clients then. You can work with people in a much more intensive way and a much more personalized way when you have fewer people that you are trying to support. So what is the big takeaway here? Some people only want the best of the best. Are you providing that option to them? Do you have a higher priced, what they call premium offer? Or are all of your offers really low priced so that someone looking for that wouldn't be able to find it if they came upon your website or however you're presenting yourself? So your homework, I'm giving you homework, is to make a higher priced offer. What would that look like? And also, please don't include everything but the kitchen sink in a higher priced offer. You don't have to do that. It can be very streamlined. It can simply be what you're doing now, except you quadruple the price. I am totally serious. So take this lesson to heart and leave a comment below. I'd love to hear what you think. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that I can make even more videos like these. Thank you so much for watching today. I'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.